Hello everyone, welcome you all. Today I am with another session on TestNG framework tutorial series. So this is going to be a very interesting topic and where we discuss some of the useful methods under TestNG. So we'll see one by one. And here we have few methods in TestNG like enable, depends on group, depends on method and groups. So I will discuss first on enable. So enabled is used to define class or a method to make it as active or inactive. So if we give an enable equal to true or false, so generally we will give this enabled equal to true. So this will be a by default one, so no need to provide any external again. So in case if you wanted to make it disable, for the time being you wanted to make it disable, then you need to provide false. So this means that it will be not executed when we invoke any class. So particular method will be not executed. So this will be under open and close braces at the rate. So like this we will be having in our TestNG. So let's jump into the code and we'll see this first method. Let me open my Eclipse. So here is my Eclipse, and we are discussed about the TestNG framework, installation, setup, configuration, and creating a Maven TestNG project. So in case if you are new to that, you do watch my series on that and come to this session. Now let's open my TestNG class. So I have changed the project name. So I have refactored the project name to make sure that previously it was a Maven TestNG. Now I just made it as a TestNG. So in case if you wanted to, if you are confused with the previous and current tutorial, so it is the same thing. So just I change the refactored page name. So let me open my test case. So this is my test cases that I have written in previous tutorial. So here we have a three test ng, I mean there are three tests. So here I wanted to give one of them as enabled equal to false. So this means that this method is currently disabled. So if you execute this all at once, and it will execute only two methods, that is test number two and which is another one. So let's quickly save and run. Here we have a three annotations, it means three test cases. So let's, if I go and run here, and you will see only two of them will be executed, one will be skipped. It has opened the Chrome browser. Now you can see it has launching test cases, it has verified, and here you can see it has two test cases executed. So one, there is a failure, or no, there is no failure, but we have enabled equal to false. Only one got executed. Why so? Why not the other test case? Save again. One more time I will run this. So anyhow, you can see the console log. Here it says one test case is executed, but how come it is not executed the second one? Let's see one more time. Let's execute from this time. We will execute from the XML location. So this is my test. Under test I have Maven test, and if you go and see, this is my package name. So here we need to provide package name, then after our test case, I mean the test class method. So it is a test case one. So this is a test case one. So this is test case one. So let's run it. TestNG suit. It has opened. Perform the action. Yeah, now it got executed. There is something went wrong, I think, in the previous run. Now you can see there is a two test cases passed and two only run. If you see here, we have three test cases. We have made this as disabled. So now if I make this as true now, this means that we don't need to explicitly give any true here because it will already execute this test case. So if I remove this enable equal to true also, it will run. And if you give true also, it will run. So let again go to XML again. Let's again run one more time TestNG suit. Now you can see three test runs and three passes. So which means that it has executed all. So this is a use of enable and disable, where you can do enable and disabling. So in case if you don't want to do from here, so if you don't want to do from here and you wanted to do it from XML, so how can you do that? So I will show you now how can we do that. So in our test, this is our testng XML, and under that we have this test. So under test we have an option called, so here we have a class which is open and close on the one line. So I will try to not to close this class here. So I will, in the next line I will close my class, because the methods which I am trying to provide, which is in a test. So under test class we need to provide these methods called, I will say methods, and under these methods I have few operations like include and space name equals to, in the double quotation we need to provide the names. So this is include. In case if you wanted to any exclude, or you wanted to say enable disable kind of operation, you can do include and exclude. So for that, exclude and name of the method. So which method you wanted to exclude. So let's do formatting. Now here, so under test class, under test classes class, you need to provide these methods. So these methods are belongs to my this class. This is your test cases one. So my test cases one is a class. Under that I have these three methods. So what I will do right now, I will take this test case one into include, and in exclude what I will do, I will try to make this test case two to be excluded. And similarly, if you wanted to add another condition, you can do copy this same thing. And here we have the verify support. So in the verify support, I will provide the include method. So here I am making two methods as include, one is as exclude, which is the same replica of enable disable, where we are giving the rate annotation, and here we are trying to do with the methods. So let's quickly save this and run again. Run as testng suit. So it has launched the Chrome browser. It has executing methods. There is one test case got skipped because we have made that is to be excluded. So which is test case 2. So this is how we perform include and exclude, enable equal to true or false. I hope you got this information right. So let's jump into the another method. So here we have dependent on group, dependent on methods. So we'll see first dependent on method. So what is the importance of dependent on method? In case if they you have 10 test cases, so executing one test case of method 1 is depend on executing of test case 10. So for example, a test case 1 has a module called messaging, and you have another module called home page. So unless until you have a home page, you can't click on the messaging. So in that way we can segregate any test cases like this. So now we'll go back to our test case here. So here in the red test annotation, this is my third test case. To execute this test case, I will say depends method. So this will accept the string values. So my support, verify support, depends on execution of test case 2. So I will say this is my test case 2. And here for test case 2, I will make depends on a method. My method is dependent on test case 1. So for example, if I make this as false, to show you, if I make this false here and save, so from here I will run it again, because we are saying this method is dependent on this test case 1, and the last test case is dependent on second test case. So here there is a connection between test case 3 and test case 2, but test case 1 and test case 2 relation is there, but test case 1 is false now, which means disabled. So let's run it again. Let's run it from our test, not from the suit. Here you can see you got an exception here. So why we have got exception? Because it is disabled method. So method we have given as false. So to make that as true, so I will make as true. In case if you don't want to use this enable disable, just remove this from your testng @ test annotation. And again, do a right click and run as test. Now you can see it has launched the Chrome browser, and then after you will find the test cases will be executed, right? So this is how we do this dependent methods. So this is very handy when you are trying to have pre and post conditions, or you have one test case, execution of one test case is dependent on other test case. So you can perform dependent on methods. And let's see the grouping concept now. So we have a groups here. So what is the importance of groups? So groups makes us providing a real good feature of executing different suits. So for example, if my project has smoke, functional and regression. So to execute this smoke, functional, regression, I need to segregate them accordingly. So these groups provide me that flexibility that I can make groups smoke, functional and regression as a grouping concept here. So let's jump into the test case and I will show you how can we do that. So here my test case 1. So here I need to provide this curly this open close braces, and here we can provide groups. Groups accept a string value. So here I will say smoke, and if you have only one, then you can provide as a string. If you have more than one, you need to provide in the form of array and separated by comma separation. And I will say functional. So this test case is part of smoke suit and also part of functional. And this is also a part of regression. Okay, so this test cases belongs to all these groups. So similarly, I will say this group. So I will provide groups, and under groups I will say smoke suit. And this is also belongs to functional. Okay, this is belongs to two different criteria. So similarly for the tar test case, I will do groups, and this test case is belongs to regression. So this test case is belongs to only regression. So I have a new build deployed. So first thing I need to perform smoke test suit, because any application we got from the developer, we do perform smoke suit first to test the critical functionalities working or not. So to do the same thing in automation, we groupings provide that options for us. So I will take this smoke as a grouping. So we need to execute this kind of criteria from testng XML, not from the test level. So let's go to testng.xml, and for now I will make this as commented here, because to provide a grouping concept we need to pass that before execution of any class. So we need to provide before that. So how we can provide that? So there is an tag called groups. Groups, and under groups you have a one more tag called run. Okay, under run you will have one more method called include name, and name equal to, we need to pass that group name here, and you need to end with include again. So here in this name I will provide my group name. So my group name is smoke. So under smoke, how many test cases we have? we have one, two, and only two. We have two criteria. So let's go and execute this from testng.xml. Quickly save and now run as testng suite. Something has went wrong. Let's jump back. I will try to remove this. Depends on the methods. And save. Come back here and run as testng suite. Let's run one more time. We did everything correct, but no white is getting not executed. So might be, let's go back to our test cases. Oh, this is our test cases so far we have developed, and let me provide before and after. So there is something that is not invoking this before and after classes. I will try to provide a method called always run equal to true. Let's see, always run equal to true, and after method as always run equal to true. So there might be a chances that it might not getting invoke this before and after classes. So I have defined always run option as true for before and after classes, because they by defaultly use the same option, but explicitly I'm providing that option to again rewrite the existing one. So let's again run the testng suite here, and I think this time it got invoked our before and after classes, and it is launched the web driver, and it is launching the test cases to be executed. It has perform that. So here we have done this one. So in case if you wanted to exclude some other groups, so here we have provided these groups like smoke, functional regression, and functional regression. So now I wanted to do like this condition, I wanted to exclude this smoke and functional. So I will take these options here and I will put it here. So this time what I will do, I will tell exclude name equal to my name and end with. Now I will do the same thing, I will exclude this option here too and I will click this save. So here what I did, I have excluded smoke and functional, that means it has to run only my regression. So now it has to run regression test cases. Let's go and run as suite again. This time it has launched. It has performed, and here you can see only one test case got executed. We have three test cases, but it has executed only one, because the reason, because we have excluded these groups. So excluded smoke functionals, excluded smoke and regression. So what else we have? We have group called regression. So this is the only case that is not excluded. So only regression is available here. So it has executed one test case here. So now let's see the dependent on groups. So far we have seen the enable method and groups. And depends on groups and depends on methods we have seen. Now we will see depends on group. So what is depends on group? So this depends on group provides you like if I have group here and I need to click on a groups which is dependent on a particular group. So you have provided a smoke for one set of group and another set of group has a functional. So to execute this functional, I will say system to execute smoke suit first. So how can we do that thing using a dependent on group? So dependent on group provide you a functional suit execution will depend on smoke suit execution. So I can provide in a similar way where regression is also dependent on smoke. So how can we achieve this in the test cases? So here, if we go back to the test cases, and this is the test cases so far we have seen. And now here we have a group, here we have a group, and let's say I will remove these groups. So for example, I will say one by one, only one group belongs to one group. So this group belongs to Yan. Now you can see this test set of test case is depend on smoke, and this is functional, this is regression. So I wanted to execute this functional. So to execute this functional, I need to execute smoke first. So how can we write a condition here? So we have condition like depends. So we have depends on a group. So depends on which group? So this depends on my smoke, right? So this depends on smoke. So this is just smoke. I wanted to execute before my functional is getting executed. Similarly, in the regression, what I will do, this regression is depend on my functional suit. So after executing functional only, I need to execute regression. So similarly, I will say depends on a group which is called functional, and this not only depends on functional, this also depends on smoke as well, because smoke need to execute, right? So for that I will provide curly braces, because more than one we need to provide in the form of array. So here I will say smoke, because this will also a part of smoke and functional. So before we execute this regression, I wanted to perform smoke and functional. And if I wanted to execute functional only, then I need to execute smoke. So first I will do functional. So to execute this functional, it has to execute smoke. So I will now remove this line. I will say smoke to functional, and I will include this. So this condition is saying to verify the condition which is included as functional. So I will quickly save and run as testng suit. It has launched the browser. It has launched the URL as well, and it has performed take cases, and it has executed two test cases. We have three, but it has executed two. The reason behind this is, if you go back to again the test cases, functional is provided for only one test case, where functional is dependent on smoke. So smoke is a one test case, so total of two. So now what I will do, I will give now regression here. Now again go back here and run as testng suit. So it has launched three different test cases, because we have provided regression, but this regression is dependent on functional and smoke. So I hope this session is useful for you. In case if you are new to my channel, please do subscribe to my channel, and there are more sessions coming on testng framework tutorial series. So do stay tuned and subscribe. Thank you for watching.